Great Talk Radio starts here.
Welcome back to the Nutramedical Report, and Dr. Coffman, of course, the intergovernmental panel on climate change, of course, is a scam. We have 37,000 scientists have now stated that there's no evidence for this. The media ignores it. There are a bunch of co-criminals in it. We have Igor ready to be the first carbon credit billionaire. It just goes on and on. And this tax literally is an international tax. It's not even going to be money going back somehow to America, like spend $8 to save one. It's going to go to international coffers for a world eco-police, for enforcement, for laws, for literally a new international bureaucracy of ecomaniacs that are going to make sure that people in Angola cannot use charcoal to cook their food and sell their carbon credits so first world countries can continue to have some of the basics they used to enjoy as natural order of law. And they don't address the pollution, the heavy metals being released by smokestacks or the burning of trash. They just deal with carbon dioxide as a trapping gas, when in fact the measures they're talking about, like geoengineering the Earth with nanoparticles at 73 to 80,000 feet, the coefficient of thermal irradiation to the Earth shows it actually increases global warming, which of course they're not succeeding, because the issue is the sun. The issue is volcanism. It is not humans. It's just absolutely obscene. And these people need to go to prison for what I call a form of scientific fraud crime, including the scientists that signed these foolishness, the politicians, the media. They all need to go to prison and throw away the key.
No, I totally agree with you. And even worse than that, Dr. Bill, is the fact that because of Al Gore's movie Inconvenient Truth, our kids are being brainwashed, but all in addition to that, they're being scared to death. I don't know how many parents have told me that their kids are afraid that they're going to be drowning or that they're going to be burning up or whatever the case might be because of global warming. I mean, this is a, if this was in any other arena that you were basically terrorizing kids, you would go to prison. And yet here Al Gore and our Congress and our president and so forth are doing it just without any type of basic any media confrontation whatsoever. It is beyond belief. I just cannot believe how they can get away with this kind of indoctrination, propaganda, and scaremongering without having it being challenged by the media. It's gotten to the point where I just call the mainstream media the Ministry of Propaganda, because that's what Hitler had and so forth with Goebbels and others. It is nothing more than the mouthpiece for the government, whatever they want to do. I can't overemphasize that enough.
Yeah, now climate deniers is what they want to call people like me. And I'm a charter member, one of the founding members of Greenpeace. I'm a marine oceanographer before I went into medicine 40 years ago. And I'm going to tell you people out there, don't challenge me or don't challenge Dr. Coffman without facts. Don't do ad hominem attacks or say I'm not a doctor or a scientist. You're an idiot, okay? And you're going to die in your ignorance and your stupidity. Your desire to attack the messenger is a form of lethal radioactive stupidity. You need to wise up. Stop wasting time listening to the talking heads in the news media. Turn off the damn TV. Your children that are listening to it, they disagree with you because their heads are filled with thousands of hours of foolishness and newspeak. They do not have the capacity to critically look at the facts that 80% of the glaciers on Earth are increasing, 10% are decreasing, only over areas where there is a drought, or they're sitting over areas like in the ocean at the Ross Ice Shelf in Antarctica, where they're directly over volcanism that's increasing under the oceans, or 10% are not changing at all. It's a lie. It's a lie. The polar bear lie. The IPCC is not reliable. Can we get into some of these issues? Because people need to understand this cap and trade is estimated over $1.83 trillion with dollars impact on the economy. It is the final death knell to America and the world economy.
Yes, it is. It really is. And for all that pain that you have to go through to make it work, it might reduce the global temperature by 0.09 degrees centigrade by 2050. That's not even measurable in today's ability to measure climate. It's not even part of the noise that we find from year to year. It is so absurd that it's just absolutely ludicrous. I mean, it's not ludicrous. It's absolutely insane. There is no other way that you can describe this. There is no evidence. And as you said, 37,000 scientists have basically said there is no convincing evidence that man is causing global warming. It is all based on computer models.
Right,
and the recent research that just come out in the last year that I'm doing videos on right now show very clearly that those have wrong assumptions, hugely wrong assumptions.
Well, and the first is that we have liquid cooling,
high
too.
Numbers after 100 years. If you actually put the correct information in, what is found is that it might raise the temperature by half a degree centigrade over the 100 years, which is nothing but, you know, that's gravy. The warmer the temperature is to a degree, the better off Earth is, the better off ecosystems are, the better off humanity is. Every evidence in past history has demonstrated this. If it's a half a degree centigrade, that is fantastic. Right now, we have lost a half a degree centigrade because of the global cooling that we've been experiencing since 2000. It is, and that's causing food shortages.
Well,
there have been some warnings going out there that this year we may not have sufficient amount of food to feed the world if we have a short growing season, which it appears that is happening because of frosts and bad weather and so forth.
Record cold.
Varying states and so forth. It is. We're in a very dangerous situation.
Yeah. This is an example. What I like people to remember, and I always find metaphors helpful. Remember Eric the Red and Leif the Lucky. When they arrived in the New World 1,000 years ago, they were during a time when it was literally global warming during a minimal period. During the Middle Ages, that's why in Northern England they grew grapes, they had all kinds of crops.
Right.
When they arrived in the New World, they called it Vinland or Vineland because there were so many grapes there in places like Newfoundland and Nova Scotia that had climates that were much like Southern France. It was done that time, for example, that's why centuries later when they had the mini ice age, it wiped out the Viking colonies in Iceland and Greenland. And the fact is it wiped them out in Greenland because it got so cold they froze to death. Now, people don't understand this. If that happens in the prairies and in Western Canada, we're not just talking about food shortages in North America. We supply 120 nations with their staple foods. There'll be food riots around the world, and there'll be billions dying. And we're not talking about centuries or decades. We're talking about next year. This is happening right now. We have massive Baltic Dry Index shortages. We have massive food crop problems. We have credit problems, so the farmers aren't planting. And now on top of it, they add the cap and trade. This is a eugenics plan. This is evil. This is a global tax. Obama needs to be impeached on this alone. This is enough to impeach him. They need to start impeachment proceedings today.
I would certainly support that idea. Unfortunately, 60% of the American people think he's doing a great job.
He's a nut, and he's going to kill us all.
Least. I don't think there's quite that many anymore that think he's doing a great job. But it's one of those things where it's a real dichotomy. Most people do not like what he is doing, but they still like him as president. I don't understand that. When you're doing things that can hurt the nation, can really cause massive destruction to the economy and so forth, how can you like the person that does it? How come you still want him in the office doing more? Doesn't make any sense to me.
They treat the presidential office like it's a late night entertainment show host. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. We'll be back in a moment with more with Dr. Mike Coffman and the real facts and how serious this is.